Hungering for an RTS with a comedic twist and deck-building mechanics? Perfect, because we're serving one up with Necronator Dead Wrong.
Hi, my name is Chris Anthony. I'm the game director for Necronator Dead Wrong, and I'm also the CEO and founder of Toge Productions. So Necronator Dead Wrong is a micro RTS strategy game that's mixed with roguelike deck building gameplay. So imagine a tower defense game, but mixed with Slay the Spire style deck building, where you play as the villain that summons the undead units, and your goal is to destroy the kingdom's castle. So it's like reverse tower defense with deck building and card mechanics.
The game is described as a comedic micro RTS. For those that are unfamiliar, what is the difference between a micro RTS and a regular full-scale RTS?
The term micro RTS, it means a smaller scale real-time strategy game. We don't have that full-scale mechanic where you have to build your base and etc. But we focus more on a smaller specific real-time strategy. So for example, in Necronator, you don't have to build bases, but you only have to manage like which type of unit that you want to spawn and in which direction should they move, like which path should they take.
Is there a learning curve in Necronator Dead Wrong, or is it approachable for newcomers to RTS and deck building style games?
So one of the reasons why we want to make Necronator as a micro RTS combined with deck building is because we feel like classic RTS games, it has a very high entry barrier. Newcomers, they sometimes couldn't directly play the game. They have to learn all the mechanics first. They have to understand like the dynamics of the units and so on. So we want to lower that entry barrier. So you have to only focus on spawning units and figuring out which path that you should send them to destroy the enemy's castle. You also utilize your cards, your decks. Anybody who never played RTS before or deck building games before, they could try this game and could understand it really, really quickly. Even though it has a low entry barrier, it's easy to learn, easy to play, but very hard to master. So if somebody who really loves the game, they could play the game over and over and figure out new strategies, figure out new tactics or new meta that they could use to win the game, basically. And there's also, the game is randomly generated, so players have to adapt, like for example, like which type of cards you should choose during a gameplay, because in every run, you can have the different possibilities of what kind of card that you get. So you have to adapt and learn what's the best way to utilize those cards in your strategy. On top of that, you can also customize your deck at the end of every battle. You can draft new cards, you can get random encounters or event encounters that you can get rewarded with new cards. And it's up to the player to figure that out, like what is the best way or like what's their chosen playstyle or their favorite strategy. And you can choose, at the moment we only have one commander, but in the future we'll have more commanders in the game. Every commander have their own abilities, their own decks, set of decks and cards. Player can, you know, unlock new cards and they can, you know, choose and customize like which one they want to use.
The Necronator itself has a really cute, memorable design. How did the Necronator come into being and how are they incorporated into the game itself?
Yeah, so funny story is the design for the Necronator, the cute bat, is because one day I was arguing with Jonathan, our COO. He wanted to have a character that's very cute and memorable that people would love, and we were arguing like what kind of character would that be and so on and so on. Hearing our argument, our artists in the back, they started drawing and sketching, scribbling on their own design. We haven't even finished arguing, and then they come into the room and showed like, okay, this is gonna be the Necronator. Okay, that's pretty cute. So, and then that stuck with the game. The lore in the game was the Necronator, the ultimate, you know, necromancer, the most powerful necromancer in the world, accidentally cursed himself and turned himself into a bat, a hopeless, you know, a powerless bat. And he's trying to to coerce other commanders and their other undead or like evil villains to basically help him regain that power. That becomes, you know, the story for the Chubat.
Do you have an early access roadmap for Necronator Dead Wrong for gamers to follow, such as when additional commanders will be released?
Yeah, we actually have the roadmap posted in the Steam store page. You can find, you can check that out. And we'll be updating the game every 2 weeks, and usually big updates comes in once in a month. Yeah, basically we'll keep updating new content until the game is fully complete.
When do you expect the game to release out of early access, and do you plan to port the game to other platforms like Xbox One or Switch?
Hopefully we'll have the game fully completed by this year. We don't have an exact date at the moment. Yes, we do hope we could bring this to other platforms, but at the moment we couldn't make any promises yet, so fingers crossed.
Take it from us, Necronator is a ton of fun. Even better, it's available on Steam right now.